everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new here. If you are new here, most of my videos are lighthearted and fun. However, I felt that it would be wrong to ignore the situation that's going on right now, and I felt like it would be wrong to continue making fun and lighthearted content when there's so much serious stuff going on right now. So if you are new here, this is a little bit different than my normal videos. But welcome anyway. So first, I just wanted to say that I really do not want to spend too much time talking about this because I am not the person that you should be listening to. You need to be listening to people of color who have these experiences on a daily basis, and that is not myself. And in no way am I trying to take that platform away from them. In no way am I trying to take their voice away from them. I do not want this to be about me at all. I merely just want this to be educational. And I think that white people remaining silent on these issues is a huge reason why we still have these issues today. So again, I really just want this to be educational for the people who are not already on board with the movement that is going on right now. If you are on board and you're either a person of color or you're an ally, then you can keep watching. That's fine. But I am definitely not making this video to get likes, to get attention. I am not making this video to get subscribers. So I do not want to spend too much time on this, but I also feel like I have a lot to say about it just based on things that I've been seeing posted on social media and stuff like that from people who I personally know and really did not think that they thought like that. If I do leave anything out or if I say anything wrong, please don't be rude about it. I am here to learn. I'm very open-minded. I am here to educate myself and I would like to continue learning. So if I do say something wrong, please just let me know in the comments. I also know for a fact that I'm going to forget some things, and that doesn't mean that I don't care about it, that just means that I forgot it. I'm human. It also goes for other influencers and celebrities who are speaking their mind and stuff like that. Please think about their intentions. Most of them have really, really good intentions. Some people are just not as educated on it, but they still feel like they want to speak about it and stand with the people who are fighting for literally their lives. So please just think about their intentions and kindly correct them or inform them if they say something wrong. There's no need for hate. There's no need to cancel people over this. Most people genuinely just want to learn more about it, especially people who do not have the experiences that people of color have. We need to learn more about it. We need to educate ourselves about it. We need to educate each other about it, because it's not people of color's job to educate ourselves, and we don't deserve a medal for being educated about it and for caring about it, because this is something so basic. Caring about other people is something so basic. We don't deserve crazy recognition or propping up on any sort of pedestal because we care about human lives and because we care about these matters. That should be like the standard. Caring about it is like the bare minimum. We need to be educating people about it. We need to be educating ourselves as much as we can. There's always room to learn and to grow. And we need to continue talking about it. And most importantly, we need to continue listening to the people who do have those experiences, who have lived through this, and who continue to deal with it, and who will continue to deal with it after these protests stop. Those are the voices that are most important. Those are the voices that need to be amplified. And if you really don't have time, I beg you to please not watch this video. Please go watch a video by a person of color. Again, please do not think that I am making this for any sort of attention for myself or to take anything away from people of color. I really just want to educate. I think it's a totally normal thing to want to talk about things that are going on around you, even though they don't happen to you personally. But again, I can only speak so much on it because these are not my experiences. I'm also just feeling very like overwhelmed with emotions and stuff because it is so powerful and like moving to see people all over the country and people literally all over the world. So many other countries have held protests in solidarity with Black Americans. And I think that that is so incredible, and it just makes me so happy. Like, I feel like, I don't know. So I really, really do not mean this to be selfish, and I'm really sorry if it comes across that way. I hope nobody thinks I'm being selfish. It's just so moving to me to see all of this happening, as I'm sure it is for so many other people, especially the people who this directly affects. I want to do as much as I can to help, and I have been doing as much as I think I can to help. If you haven't done those two basic things, I strongly urge you to check out the links that I have below that has all of the petitions and all of the places that you can donate. You can also buy supplies and hand them out to people who are protesting or just people who need them. There are so many ways to help during this that are not being out on the front lines protesting. And honestly, every way is equally just as important. In my mind, this is one of the ways that I can help talk about it. I think white people remaining silent is a huge part of the issue, as I said, so I do not want to remain silent. I really do not want this to be about me. I am just going to be stating what I am seeing, what I'm interpreting, and just what's going on merely for educational purposes. I'm not going to be talking about myself at all because it's not about me. I also want to acknowledge that I know that people are going to disagree with me and what I'm saying, and that's totally fine. But I hope that we can fundamentally agree that the latest incident with George Floyd is objectively wrong. The officers murdered him, and there is no question about that. And I also hope that we can objectively agree that it is wrong for any police officer to abuse their power to hurt or to murder any civilian at all, whether they're a person of color or not. It's still wrong, and it's an abuse of power, and those police officers do not get held to the same standards that we would get held to if we went out and did the same thing that they did, like we as citizens. Throughout this video, I am going to be saying we. I mean we as people, we as citizens, and we as protesters. I am not equating myself to a person of color. If it does sound that way, I'm really sorry. That's not what I'm trying to do. I also hope that we can fundamentally agree that human life is valuable, and that it is so much more valuable than property, than money, and than material items. So with that being said, I want to go into the main thing that people seem to be focusing on about these protests, which is the rioting and looting that is going along with it. While I do not think that rioting and looting is the right answer, I also know for a fact that most of the people who are protesting are trying to stop the people who are rioting and looting. They are not the same people. People who are rioting and looting, in many cases, are selfish and have their own motives and are just trying to come up on free stuff, whereas the people protesting are really trying to get a message across. So please do not let the acts of a few people diminish the message that's trying to be said and cloud the message that's trying to be said and distract you from what they are really trying to do and what they're really trying to say. However, if it was the protesters rioting and looting, I can definitely see where they're coming from. Again, not saying that I condone it, that I think it's the right answer, but I get it. People of color specifically have been oppressed for so long and have been pushed to their limits and have seen absolutely no change as a result of their peaceful protests. So I understand why anger is the reaction that was had when they've just been pushed to their boiling point. However, I've also seen the videos, and I know that people of color, for the most part, are not the ones doing the rioting and looting. It's mostly white people. One reason that people have a huge problem with the rioting and looting is that many of the businesses that are getting rioted and looted are small businesses owned by minorities, which is incredibly sad, and I hope that after all of this, we can come together as a community to support those small businesses, especially those that are minority owned, and build them up and make them better than ever. However, while I feel bad for those businesses and the people who own them, I also think that there's a point to be made with all of this. I don't know if this point is intentional. I really don't think it is, because again, the people protesting are not the people who are rioting and looting. But I do see a greater point in all of this. I'm sure other people see it as well, but I personally have not seen it pointed out on social media, so I thought maybe I would do it in here. As we're sitting home watching our businesses, our friends' businesses, and businesses in our communities that we enjoy going to get destroyed, we feel helpless. But imagine if we went out there and tried to protect those businesses. You would definitely be outnumbered, which is a terrifying feeling. You may also have friends or family or children or parents or what, I mean, that's family, but you know what I mean. You may also care about somebody who is a police officer during this time, and it's really scary to have them out there when the riots do start, when they start to get violent. It's scary because you don't know if your parent or your son or your daughter or your aunt or your uncle or your friend or your neighbor or whoever, if they're going to be the next ones hurt during these riots. And again, you feel helpless, and it's a really terrifying feeling. But what people need to understand is that this is how people of color feel every single day for their entire lives. Whether these protests are going on or not, they are constantly afraid for their life, and they are constantly wondering when they will be next, when their friends will be next, when their parents, their children, their neighbors, their aunt, their uncle, their cousin, when whoever will be the next one killed by police. And not if they'll be the next person killed by police, but when, because it's really likely that they will be killed by police. So yes, it's extremely sad that these businesses are going to have to spend so much time and money to rebuild, and some of them may not even have the resources to do so. But it's also important to know that property and merchandise is far less important than human lives, and those things can be replaced, and human lives cannot be. People are also mad for some reason about like Target and CVS being looted, which, like, I get it. It's not right to steal things. But also, those are billion-dollar corporations. They have insurance. They have a ton of money. This is like a very small dent in their finances. They will come back. They will continue to make profits. They will be completely fine. Even the CEOs and even the owners of small businesses have publicly stated that they understand why this is the response. And while they're sad for their businesses and their companies, they understand why it's the response, and they still support the Black Lives Matter movement. So if you're worried about these ginormous corporations that literally don't care about you as a single person, they just care about your money like as a whole, but not about you as a single person, then what you're telling me is that you value property, you value money, and you value material items more than you value human lives. Next, I want to go into an excuse that I've pretty much heard my entire life and honestly have used when I was younger, but as I've become more educated and more knowledgeable of the situations that go on in our society, I've understood why this statement is wrong. And that's the statement that a few bad apples don't ruin the whole bunch. This is specifically used to refer to police officers, saying that a few bad police officers do not represent the whole entirety of the police force, which I understand it's a very small percentage of police officers who are considered bad apples. There are so many good police officers who are doing their jobs for the right reason, who really want to protect people, who really want to help people, who are here for the right reasons. But there's a small percentage of those who are not. And I know that being a police officer is incredibly hard and it's a demanding job and not everybody can do it. But the problem with that is that the requirements to become a police officer are so incredibly low. They are so minimal that it is so easy to become a basic police officer. I'm not saying like higher ranks, but a basic police officer, the ones who are out here on the streets giving tickets and killing people, like we give them guns, they meet these very minimal requirements, yet they're asked by our government, by their police chief, and by us as a community to do those very difficult jobs well and to do them correctly. Yet they don't receive the training or the vetting to ensure that they are the right people to be doing that job correctly or to make sure that they do that job correctly. And they're also not held accountable for doing that job incorrectly, which is where the good apples come in. The good police are good cops. They don't do anything bad, but they're just as bad as the bad cops if they don't speak up against the bad cops. I have friends who are police officers and they've told me that if they stood up for the criminals' basic rights that they took an oath to protect, then the whole department would literally like out them and like not have their back in like any situation after that, which is basically how a gang operates, and it can be incredibly ostracizing and incredibly dangerous to the police officer who was just trying to do the right thing, which is why a lot of good police officers do not stand up to bad police officers. If there are so many more good police officers than bad police officers, then that should not be the case, because the good police officers should stand up for the good police officers and have their back when the bad police officers don't, because again, apparently there's only a small percentage of bad cops. Yet the whole department is able to completely leave one of their own for dead, basically, when they do something that they don't like. Another thing that's really important to note is that police officers have a duty to protect our life and to protect our safety, and yet when they don't do that, they get to continue doing that job and they're just called bad apples, but they don't experience any repercussions for not doing the duty that they took an oath to perform. So because the job of being a police officer is so incredibly important to the community and the lives of the people in the community, they should not be able to have bad apples. Not all jobs get to have bad apples. Pilots can't just ignore landing protocol. Doctors can't discriminate who they're operating on or just decide to skip steps in a surgery or whatever. Construction workers can't decide that they just don't want to measure things because your house would collapse, your building would collapse. Like, not all jobs get to have bad apples, and I don't understand why police officers get a free pass. That is one of the jobs that it should definitely not be okay to have bad apples. Even retail stores do not have bad apples, and their job is far less important than being a police officer. They are not responsible for people's lives. So if you're one of those people saying that not all cops are bad cops and bad apples don't ruin the whole bunch, then you need to keep that same energy when only a small percentage of the protesters are looting. They're not the same. They don't have the same message, but it's a very small percentage of people who are out there looting. And those looters do not define the entire movement and the protests that are going on. And you also need to keep that same energy when you're assuming that all people of color are criminals, because they're not. It's a very small percentage. Again, white people commit crimes too, yet you don't think that all white people are criminals. Many people believe Donald Trump when he says that all people who come here from Mexico are rapists and are criminals. But if you don't believe that all cops are bad cops, then you need to realize that not all black people are criminals, not all people of color are criminals, not all protesters are looters. It's the exact same thing, yet people don't see the similarities. I don't get it. Finally, I really want to go into what these protests are about, kind of. So I've been hearing a lot about like, oh, all of the violence and the rioting and whatever is like tarnishing George Floyd's memory and all that kind of stuff. And what I have to say to that is that this was about George Floyd for about a day, and it's still technically about George Floyd, but it is also about all of the other people of color who were needlessly killed by police officers. It's about all of the people of color who will continue to be needlessly killed by police officers. And this is about all of the police officers who have gotten and will continue to get off scot-free, facing absolutely no repercussions for their actions, for literally murdering people because of their badge, because of their uniform, because of their rank, and because of their skin color. This is not the first time that we've seen protests about this situation, and this is not the last time that we will see protests about this situation. People of color, and specifically black people, have been protesting racial injustice for literally centuries. So again, this is no longer only about George Floyd. This is about so much more. It is so much bigger than just a single person or two people or three people. It's about so many people. I don't even know how many people have been murdered by police officers. I know that we as a whole know some of their names, but we definitely do not know all of their names. I also want to acknowledge that I know that this is going on all the time, not just when there's protests happening, not just when it's all over the media and all over the news, not just when there's hashtags being made for people. I know that this is happening all the time. But right now, we as a community are so incredibly strong in sending our message that I think this is a very important time to be supporting the movement. And honestly, people are hating on people who have never spoken out about this issue before, but I personally am just really happy that people are talking about it now, and rather than just staying silent and not saying anything at all about it. Better late than never, right? So I also hear that this is not the right way to protest. This is not the right way to get your message across. And to the people who are saying that, I just have to ask, what is the right way to protest? Because these people have been protesting peacefully. They have been protesting the way that you want them to protest for so long. You want them to be peaceful and you want them to have meaningful conversations, but what you fail to acknowledge is that people of color's voices are often not heard in spaces where meaningful conversations happen. They are left out of those conversations which are supposed to be about them, and then no change gets made. Also, is anybody surprised that it's come to this? When women were protesting for their rights and they didn't get it, it turned into riots, and then women got equal rights. LGBTQ people protested to have their voices heard, to have the same rights as straight people, and nobody took them seriously, nobody listened to them, no change happened. But then the Stonewall riots happened and we saw change, and LGBTQ people got many of the same rights that straight people have. Not all of the same rights, but many of the same rights. People of color, and specifically black people, have been protesting to have equal rights as white people for literally centuries. Black people even protested peacefully when our country made them 3/5 of a person. Literally not even a whole person. Like, before that, they were not seen as a person, and then they were seen as 3/5 of a person, like kind of a person, which is so incredibly messed up. Yet much of our society continues to not see them as people. Society sees them as criminals, they see them as animals, and they just see them as less than white people, and that is an objective fact. If you do not believe that that is the case, then good for you. You are incredibly privileged that you don't have to see that or experience that. Saying that this isn't the correct way to protest or to get their message across is also incredibly wrong, because basically what you're saying is that that's the way that you want them to protest. You want them to protest peacefully. You want them to have those meaningful conversations, and not to say that those won't happen and they aren't happening, but what you're saying is that that's how you would like them to display their anger. The problem is that it's not about you, and it's not your choice, and it's not your place to tell them how they should or should not react to things. It's very likely that you are not the person going out and hurting and killing these people, and the people who are doing that are violent people. They use violence and they understand violence. So violence is a completely valid way to get the point across to people who will only listen to violence. The protests that I have seen growing up on this topic, people make it seem like even peaceful protests are extremely inconvenient for them. They make them uncomfortable. Now that it's more than just one or a few people kneeling for the national anthem, it's people marching and even people getting a little bit violent. Again, those are not the same people protesting. They do not have the same message. Some people are getting violent because they are angry, and it's completely understandable. And again, people are uncomfortable and they are very inconvenienced by the protests. And again, it is not about you. It's not about your feelings, and it's not about what you want. Also, I just want to point out that that is the exact point of protests. No change gets made when people are comfortable. If you're inconvenienced or you're scared for your neighbors or your friends or your neighborhood or whatever, that's how they feel every single day. That's how people of color feel all the time. And you're getting a little taste of it. I think the protests have been going on for what, like a week now? And you're already crying because you're inconvenienced and you're scared and you're uncomfortable. But that's exactly the point. That's how they feel all the time. And you're getting a little taste of it and you honestly can't handle it. If you could handle it, you would understand that yes, while it is mildly inconveniencing and while it is mildly uncomfortable, very uncomfortable for some people, it's what needs to happen in order for change to be made and you would deal with it. Basically, what you're saying when you say that is that you want them to protest in a way that you can continue ignoring, just as you and your parents and your grandparents and everyone else has for I don't even know how long. Also important to note that these protests are about injustice and the fact that our justice system is broken. 99% of these police officers literally get to get away with murder and continue doing their jobs and continue living their lives as if everything's completely normal. Yet people of color who are exhibiting absolutely no criminal behavior, who are not criminals, have no criminal record, or honestly, even if they do have a criminal record, they're being sent to jail in alarmingly huge numbers, way more than white people. They're getting less chances and less leeway than white people are getting for far worse crimes. For example, Brock Turner literally raped a woman. It was confirmed, and he got 6 months in jail, and then he got off after 3 months because of good behavior and whatever. They didn't want to tarnish his reputation and like poor Brock Turner. White men literally go into schools with giant guns and kill children and teachers, people who are trying to teach those children, and they get very calmly escorted out of the school with a bulletproof vest provided by the police. And then they get excuses made for them, such as they have mental illnesses or they were bullied or whatever sad story they decide to give you. But nobody wants to give people of color the benefit of the doubt and say that, oh, maybe they have a mental illness. Maybe the way that they were brought up because of systemic racism led to their actions, and nobody takes that into account. But white people, for the most part, get a pass. Even if white people go to jail, the process of getting them there is far less violent and they are far less likely to die throughout that process than people of color. Another example is the person who murdered George Floyd had also killed 6 other minorities at least and had at least 12 other police brutality charges against him, yet he was able to continue being a police officer and he was awarded an honorary medal for being a great police officer or whatever. That just goes to show you that had the public not seen this video and made all of the noise that we are making right now, then he would be able to still continue being a police officer. And again, he would have gotten off with minimal or zero consequences. For the murder of George Floyd, originally it was announced that he had received a third degree murder charge, which is basically a negligent homicide charge. It's like really nothing. But I just read this morning that it got upgraded to a second degree murder charge, which is so great. And that just shows you the power of protest, what our voices are doing, how we are creating change and how we are impacting the system. I also heard that the other 3 police officers who were involved in George Floyd's death, who literally just stood around and let it happen, the good apples, if you will, they are also being charged. I did not read what they were being charged with, but I know that they are being charged, hopefully with accessory to a crime. But again, I did not see it in the article, so I don't know for sure. I think that that is awesome, but charges being brought is not prosecution, and I hope that all 4 of these officers are prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. And while second degree murder is not first degree murder, as I'm sure many of us agree it was first degree murder, it's still progress, because literally before this, no police officer was being held accountable for their actions for the most part. So while it may not be ideal, progress is still progress, and hopefully we will continue to make more progress from here. So I am sorry that this is so incredibly long. I really didn't intend for it to be this long. However, I just felt like there was a lot that I needed to say about it that I wanted to educate people on, and just a lot of stuff that I wanted to talk about. I also just want to make it clear, if you have made it this far, please go watch other people's videos on this. Please go listen to people of color, go talk to people of color, go have a conversation with them, and really listen to what they have to say. They experience this on a daily basis. They know this better than anybody else. And although I will never understand what it's like to be a person of color, and especially a person of color dealing with the police in America, I and others can open our eyes to the injustice and inequality that's literally right in front of us and try our best to educate ourselves and to understand the pain that so many people in our country are feeling right now and all the time. I know in many of these cases, there are passionate protests for a few days and then people forget about it and move on with their lives. I sincerely hope that this situation continues to get the attention that it deserves until real changes start to be made. It's also important to note that while you may have the privilege to forget about this in a few days and move on with it and just not ever think about it until it happens again, and it will happen again, people of color do not have that option. This is their lived experience every single day. This is what they deal with every single second. They are constantly afraid and angry and sad, and we expect them to act normal and to go about their lives as if nothing's wrong, as if they're not being targeted and hunted by people who are abusing their power and by people who continue to get away with that abuse of power. It's not for us to decide when enough time has passed after a situation that they have to go back to being normal. For people of color, this is their normal. normal life. And they don't get to just forget about it because they're constantly, again, wondering when they or their friends or just somebody that they care about will be next. Please remember to check in on your friends during this time. Everybody's having a really hard time, but especially people of color. Just do a mental health check and see how people are doing during this time. This is a really tough time for them. The most important part of reaching out to them is to listen to them. Don't talk over them. Don't give them your stories or whatever. You need to listen to them. They have things to say. They have experiences to talk about. They have voices that really need to be heard all the time and especially right now. Also, please remember to ensure them that they are valuable and that their feelings and their experiences matter. And please stand up with and for them in any way possible, even if that's not standing in front of them at a protest, even if that means sharing the article on social media, sharing ways that they can continue to stay safe, shutting down family members and just other people who you see on your timeline who may be sharing racist things, but especially donating to the links that I have down below and signing the petitions that I have down below. Those are the easiest things that you can be doing. Honestly, that should be the minimum. It's not enough to just stand by and acknowledge that this is a problem. You have to actively participate in the solution. The final thing that I wanted to say is that on the news during these protests, I keep hearing the anchors and people who they're interviewing, like police chiefs and stuff, saying that they hear the protesters' message, but it's always, we hear you, but. We hear you, but stop destroying businesses. We hear you, but stop responding with anger. But honestly, we have heard that before. And every time they've said that, they say they hear us and they say that change will come and then nothing happens. Because once they say that we hear us, people back down. And that is not what we need. We need to continue pushing until real change happens, until people of color are listened to and until they're understood. And again, until real change starts to get implemented. Not just they say they're going to implement change, but until real change starts to happen. Again, I am so sorry that this is so long. I really don't mean to take anything away from people of color or people who have these lived experiences. I really just wanted this to be out there for educational purposes. However, I really do not expect any like subscribers or any support for making this video because it is the least that I can do and the least that most people can do is to talk about it and get it out there. I will have a pinned comment if I forgot anything, and I'm sure I did forget some things. If you're going to be mean to other people or call them names and just disregard their support for this movement, then just please don't even comment. You probably should have clicked out of the video a while ago, but if you didn't, just exit out, go watch another video or something. Again, please just listen to the people whose voices really matter during this time, which is not me, and I fully acknowledge that. I think it's just wrong for people to stand by and not say anything and remain silent. With all of that being said, please stay safe out there, and I will see everybody in my next video. Yeah, I'll see you then. Bye.